In this video, we'll discuss the Bernoulli distribution and maximum likelihood estimation. Consider a biased coin flip. The probability of heads is given by 0.2, and the probability of tails is given by 0.8. It turns out we can represent both probabilities with one parameter, which we'll denote by theta. The probability of heads is simply given by theta, and the probability of tails is 1 minus theta. We can observe the likelihood of a sequence of events by multiplying the probability of each event together to obtain the likelihood. For example, we have a heads. The probability of observing one head is 0.8. Consider the second flip. We observe a second head, and to obtain the likelihood of observing that sequence, we simply multiply 0.8 times 0.8. For the third flip, we obtain a tail. To obtain the likelihood of observing that sequence, we simply multiply 0.8 times 0.8 times 0.2. And the likelihood of that sequence is 0.096. Now consider the case where we don't know the likelihood. Let's record the likelihood for two different values of the parameter, theta equals 0.5 and theta equals 0.2. We have the first flip, and the likelihood of observing a head for the first value of the parameter is 0.5, and for the second parameter is 0.2. We observe a second flip.
In this case, it's tails.
For the parameter theta equals 0.5, the value of the likelihood is given by 0.25. For the value of the parameter 0.2, the value of the likelihood is 0.16. We continue for a third flip, and the likelihood for the parameter theta equals 0.5 is 0.125, and the value for the parameter of 0.2 is 0.032. And for the following sequence, the likelihood for theta equals 0.5 is 0.0625 and 0.025 respectively. Now if we look at the actual sequence, it turns out the probability of heads or tails is equally likely, i.e. the parameter of theta equals 0.5 is much more likely to generate the sequence. And if we look at the corresponding likelihood for that parameter value of 0.5, we see it's significantly larger than the likelihood for the corresponding parameter of 0.2. So it turns out we can obtain the parameter by finding the parameter values that maximizes the likelihood. So we could represent the Bernoulli distribution as a function. Probability that y equals 0 is given by the following, and the probability that y equals 1. This is a function of theta. We can also obtain an expression for the likelihood, which is a function of theta. We simply multiply the Bernoulli distribution for all the independent samples together, and we get a function. Our goal is to find the value of the parameter theta that maximizes this function. It's helpful to visualize it as follows, where each of the individual probabilities is a function multiplied together. The likelihood function is represented by the overlapping values, and the goal is to find the value of the parameter that maximizes this function. It turns out that it's simple to maximize the log of the likelihood function, given by the following expression. Because the log is monotonically increasing, it may change the shape of the function, but does not change the location of the maximum value for the parameter theta. And that's it.